गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 8 स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई वेलकम यू टू आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स विच इज रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज ऑफ मेटल्स. इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव सीन दैट हाउ मेटल्स रिएक्ट इजीली विद ऑक्सीजन, वाटर, एसिड्स, राइट. नाउ इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल लर्न व्हाई एंड हाउ द मेटल्स रिएक्ट. नाउ let us see what is the meaning of reactivity series of metals. Reactivity series, which is also known as activity series, it is the arrangement of metals in the descending order or decreasing order of their reactivity with other elements. Metals react easily with oxygen in air or water or acids, dilute acids, but reactivity series is the arrangement of the metals, different metals. Here we have written few names which are mostly in use. According to their decreasing order of reactivity, so metals which are placed above, like sodium, potassium, calcium, these are most reactive. Whereas metals towards the down or after hydrogen, these are least reactive. Therefore, in the activity series or reactivity series, metals are placed according to their decreasing order or descending order of reactivity. Reactivity decreases as we go down in the series. Reactivity decreases as we go down in the series, and it increases as we go up. Okay, it is because now we will look at the features. Actually, reactivity series give an idea or information about how the metals react with other elements, and whether it also tells us whether a metal can displace another metal in a solution, or whether a metal is able to react with acids or bases or not. Okay, so looking at the reactivity series, we can say that the most reactive metals displace the metals which are placed below them. So metals placed higher in the series are more reactive than those placed below. Therefore, let's see what are the features of reactivity series. Number one, more reactive metals tend to lose electrons readily from their atom and form cations. Electrons are the negatively charged particles. Cation is formed when an electropositive element loses electron from its atomic structure. Therefore, a cation is a positively charged particle formed from an electropositive element like metals. For example, say when potassium atom or sodium atom lose electron, they form positively charged particles.
that is catalyst. Potassium atom when lose electron it will form potassium ion, that is cation. Similarly, sodium can lose one electron and will form cation, that is sodium ion. Potassium ion, sodium ion. In this way, metals have the tendency to lose electron easily. More reactive metals lose electrons more easily. That's why they react with oxygen, water, acids and bases faster. Being electropositive in nature, these act like reducing agent easily. Okay. Now let's see what are the other features of reactivity series. So reactivity series tells us that which metal will displace which metal in nature from its compound. Next you write feature number 2, all metals that are found above hydrogen gas. Okay, we will talk about it afterward. Now you write metals that are placed higher, metals that are placed higher in the series can displace the metals, can displace the metals that are placed lower than them. From there, salt solution. On this basis, we will read about the single displacement reaction. Be more clear when we will learn about displacement reaction of metals. Okay, so feature number 2, metals that are placed higher in the series have the ability or can displace the metals that are placed lower than them from their respective salt solution. Have the ability to displace. Okay, now next feature number 3, metals that are placed above hydrogen gas, above hydrogen, can liberate hydrogen gas. Metals that are placed above hydrogen in the series can liberate hydrogen gas upon reacting with dilute hydrochloric acid, or you can write full, or in short dilute HCl or H2SO. In the previous class we have seen that how sodium, potassium, zinc, aluminium can liberate hydrogen gas, right, from while reacting with acid. Or zinc while reacting with H2SO4. So the metals that are placed above hydrogen can liberate hydrogen gas while reacting with dilute acids. Please write this down. Now, being a non-metal, hydrogen is also placed in the activity cells, as you can see. Being a non-metal, hydrogen is also placed in the activity series, because just like metals, it can also lose one electron and attain a positive charge during electrochemical reactions. Okay? Hydrogen also can lose electron and give positive ion. Therefore, being non-metal, hydrogen is also placed in the activity series. So, these are the features of activity series. Now we will read about metal displacement reaction after the short break. Welcome back after the break. Now we will read about displacement reaction of metals. Metals that are placed towards the top of the series, or the metals which are placed above hydrogen, are more reactive. Therefore, they can displace the metals which are placed down. The reaction in which metals react with salt solutions and displace or replace the metal which is present in that salt solution are known as displacement reactions. There are two types of displacement reactions: single displacement and double displacement reactions. But in your syllabus there is only single displacement reaction. So now let us have a look on these examples. Zinc, metallic zinc. If zinc granules are dipped into the blue colored copper sulfate solution, copper sulfate which is available in the laboratory, we can easily produce the solution. And I guess you all have already experienced these activities in your previous class with iron and copper sulfate, right? So this is the displacement reaction of metals where zinc granules, when placed in the dipped in the copper sulfate solution, after a few time, slowly, the color of the copper sulfate solution will change and it will form colorless zinc sulfate solution with metallic copper displaced, metallic copper precipitated down, right? The bright shiny color we can see on the metallic copper as precipitated down. But if opposite happens, if copper granules are dipped into the zinc sulfate solution, there will be no reaction. So as you can see, the position of zinc and copper in the series, zinc is placed much higher than the copper, as copper is very less reactive. Therefore, copper cannot place copper cannot replace zinc from its solution, but zinc can replace copper from its salt solution. And copper, metallic copper is replaced. Same way, one more example, please write down in your copy. When iron nail, it's a very common activity we have already done in the previous class. When iron nail or iron chips are dipped into the blue color copper sulfate solution, copper is displaced by iron, right? And it forms slowly, that color of the solution changes into light green colored solution, which shows the presence of iron sulfate. And if we are using the iron nail, then over the surface of the iron nail there would be deposition of metallic copper, right? So there are many more examples, many more chemical reactions in your text. Please write and practice those examples. So we are done with displacement reaction. Practice all these reactions, whatever you have written, we have done in this online class. Thank you very much. Meet you in the next class.